Day, ladies and gents, welcome to episode one. Okay, it looks like we got a half decent start here.
Our explorers have spotted another friendly tribal village.
Sweet. Food's good, production's bad. Slow us down at the start. But that's okay.
Our civilization has accomplished something historic.
Hooray.
Worthy of being celebrated and remembered for generations to come. These accomplishments help our civilization reach a golden age and avoid a dark age.
So in, what is it called? Rise and Fall. They got the Dark Age stuff and Era Progress. And, you know, these are players. These are our stats. Our current score is 1 because we just found a guy. I didn't see what that said.
It is best to use caution when moving close to enemy units.
When you move close to enemy units, you can only move one spot. Anyway, so... next era, between 117 and 177 turns. You're supposed to get, just try to get at least 2 normal. If you can't get to normal, definitely try. And this is the era thing. You gotta try to get a normal. But you would like to get into the Golden Age. Being next to guys and whatnot. Pretty funny. I recorded about an hour of it for
one
episode.
It would seem we have finally tracked the barbarian raiders plaguing these lands to their source. We must destroy the stronghold or risk future attacks.
Biggest thing with barbarian hordes is you don't want them to spawn. Cavalry hordes. Because they can wipe you out early on. Generally, that doesn't happen, but I've seen it.
Our city continues to prosper.
New population, yay. That actually works very well in our favor. I recorded an entire episode. Thought I had anyway. It didn't actually record anything. That was kind of upsetting. But it turned out to be okay because of the map layout. Although the map was great, I was next to 2 people. Like, here's Kyoto for Japan. I was up here. There was one guy over here, and then there was one guy right here, right on top of me. It was bad. Should I'm gonna move a few turns more right above the seahorse. Mm-hmm.
have trained our first ranged unit, capable of hitting enemies from afar, while out of the range of hand-to-hand combat.
Lots of amber. That's nice. Generally, I like to do a worker first or a scout. I think I'm gonna go straight for settler though. As I was saying, the horse lords.
No man ever wetted clay and then left it, as if there would be bricks by chance and fortune.
Husbandry, second is mostly for stuff like horses, and well, I don't have any, but deer and whatnot. Ooh, copper, nice. Thankfully. I hate losing units early on. Huge disadvantage when you do, because it's wasted.
Reconnaissance units like scouts are...
Perfect, that means I can take... heal him, bring him... I'm gonna go around the long way. Oh, I might be on an island. Oh, that would be sweet. I will post my games, game seed and map seed in the comments below if you guys are interested in playing on the same map.
Enacting new policies in our government can be of great benefit.
At his best, man.
I always like going with God King first because it starts off the faith. And I only have the one city, so the production in all cities is kind of pointless. And I might die. Damn. I knew that was somewhere right here, too. Discover a second continent. Yeah, I did that. Cool.
Just as our citizens have faith in your leadership, so they are beginning to have faith in a higher power. I think it is wise to cultivate this new way of thinking. Perhaps there is some benefit to be gained.
Only perhaps. Tactical retreat. If he comes at me, then the spearmen can't come at me either. Or at the same time, rather. Hopefully, I survive. Scout on scout grinder.
This military unit has proven themselves. From the experience they have gained in combat, they are eligible to be granted a promotion. How will you reward these brave souls?
Land? Hooray! The kid has been defeated. The barbarians are driven away. Plus 3 air score. Nice. It is wise to kind of, if you got an island set up kind of like this, and we don't know, well, don't know for sure that's an island, but definitely probably is.
Under the white cliff's battlemented crown, hushed to a depth of more than Sabbath peace.
Nice. Natural wonder.
Through exploration, we have discovered a natural wonder of the world. There is no doubt that it could provide a great benefit to the one who settles the land surrounding it.
And it gives boast. Cultural. Angled. Teton natural wonder appears with cliffs adjacent to water and provides +3 culture and +2 gold. +3, so how are we doing? We just hit 11. We're actually doing pretty darn well. We might hit a golden age.
If there are no dogs in heaven, then when I die,
I want
to go where they went.
I like that. We're a decent-sized island. I think that Japan would get put on as a on an island state more often, but it's actually pretty rare by yourself. With any nation, actually. So that barbarian camps don't spawn. Oh, hello.
Gott grüße euch, Geselle.
Greetings.
Ich bin Kaiser Friedrich und herrsche über deutsche und welsche Lande, über Burgund und manche mehr. Ich weiß wohl, dass auch ihr Kund geherrschen mit rechter Gewalt.
It's an honor to meet you. Sweet.
There are several different types of city-states, and each may provide different benefits in return for our friendship. Our city-state neighbors have made a request of us.
They will reward us handsomely. Okay, Despa. Destroy barbarian outposts within 5 tiles of them. 1, 2, 3, so they are moved out to get them to spawn. Yeah. Production, production. Get a barbarian outpost to show up inland, not next to the sea, then I might just put my warrior guys right next to it and have them kill everything that spawns, and that's a good way to boost up your experience with these guys.
Über Vorsichtigkeit sie gelobet, zu helfen diesem Reich, hieße Tant.
Thank you. does a scout gun give me? Because this is all flatland, they can move through
the spaces. I shot an arrow into the air. It fell to earth.
Astrology. Let's do sailing first. Astrology. Good food. Tokyo.
May I make a suggestion?
Tokyo. Settling new city has expanded our civilization to an empire larger than one city. It's important to keep an eye on the loyalty of our citizens. Loyalty decreases, the city is not as effective. Loyalty drops to zero, the city will declare its independence and become a free city. The same can happen to other civilizations, so keep an eye out for opportunity to stabilize others. Maybe even take a free city into your own empire. Loyalty is mainly affected by the number of nations. Number and nationality of citizens in and near the city. Having lots of your own population with the nine tiles will improve your loyalty each turn. Population belonging to other civilizations with nine tiles will decrease it. The closer cities are together, the greater the effect is. Furthermore, the effect is greatly strengthened for civilizations in golden ages and the dark ages. Assigning a governor, which will be later, to a city will ensure it is enough. Has enough amenities and other ways to ensure loyalty of your own. Cool. So I wasn't thinking about this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So. I'm looking for loyalty. Okay, it says 100. Builder.
We have the opportunity to develop a formal trade route between two cities.
Nice.
Every nation lives by exchanging.
Gold from trade routes, production targets. No.
As our civic knowledge grows, so do our methods of governance. Furthering this endeavor will allow us to appoint a governor to strengthen our power in our cities.
Governors will greatly improve the loyalty of a city they are in, give it bonuses based on what promotions you choose for them. To appoint a new governor or promote existing ones, we need a governor. Governor titles, our main source of governor titles, complete particular civics. Six, am I at three yet? Getting there. What's this one? Do that. So next we're gonna have to build a trader. Fukuoka and Kyoto. A few reasons why I went on this side is this side, first production, second, then I'll build, and well, here one, I can build here to grab whatever land is over here, and I can build on here on either of these two. Cliff faces. definitely always better off going with those things that you have accomplished to reduce by half. That, oh, darn it. That'll definitely keep your... There we go. That'll keep your high level leader who is surrounded by impressive military. Thanks, I guess. Maybe some promotions. The unit needs orders. He's getting promoted. Faster reveal. Terrain. What is it, right? It might be a good idea just to keep these guys inside. Then we can get preparing outposts to spawn more often around us. Oh, and we just got a recon unit, of course, for that. Keeping him there because the next thing I'm building, I could go after Granary, but I think that the best thing to go after Granary is.
Isn't just our lands that can be improved, but our waters as well. I suggest.
It is not that life ashore is distasteful to me, but life at sea is better.
Trilogy next, so I can build myself a holy site, get my religion up and running. Settler. Then we'll go really into build mode for things like the monuments and whatnot. I think that'll help out. Some people might ask, why do I even do,
The number of faithful has grown, and it is time for us to define our beliefs. Let us choose a pantheon to worship.
Okay. Generally, I always go for war or healing. So, God of War is faith equal to 50% of the strength of each enemy unit killed within 8 tiles. Holy Sight. Awesome. Or increases healing by plus 30 in Holy Sight district for any adjacent tile. So, it's another spot where you're going to increase healing other than your city, or I think you can build forts as well. So, when you've got so much healing, and you're not China, who can do the Great Wall, then it's really hard to destroy country or city, or any of your cities, really. Oh, I was saying, marathon speed. Part of the biggest reason I like marathon speed is how long Stone Age and you know, pre-World One, World War One era.
My liege, we have an envoy at our disposal. We can use the envoy to gain...
Mysticism is the mystery.
So I just return. Nope, not changing nothing right now. Then... 48, 31. Is that 10? Yeah, that can reduce that by... Send an envoy to our only guy. Hopefully, Frederick doesn't get pissed.
Yeah. We have recently gained a
physician without a knowledge of astrology has no right to call himself a physician.
First, and then we'll do navigation.
Your Grace, I worry about the happiness of our citizens. I would advise that we investigate a means of increasing their contentment.
Happiness measures the contentment of your people in a single city. The population of that city has many amenities as expected. One amenity is required for two populations, starting at a population of three. Okay. So we must hit three. Yeah, we're at three, that's why. Okay, what did I say I was gonna do first? Good. And let's do rice and stone. Because rice is plus food. Or cotton. Luxury. Bonus. Eureka! Give us another amenity, I think. Irrigation, damn it. Have to wait. Mining.
Our treasury is filled with gold, and I think it could be wise to make an investment. Perhaps we could expand our military.
Okay. No.
Writing means sharing. It's part of the human condition to want to share things.
Yeah.
Thoughts, ideas, opinions.
So we got, let's do mining real quick.
Skill without imagination is craftsmanship and gives us many useful objects, such as wickerwork picnic baskets.
Million anti-cavalry and race units. Not yet. He just built a worker. And we're gonna need 1, 2, maybe 3. Should we do a holy site here, or we need to do housing? Six population go in military tradition, 30-22. So we can find to our production pick, we developed a courage. Boosted, nice. Nice, nice, nice. the workers. Let's put you to sleep well right now. I don't need a farm. Put him on alert in case there's a ship that goes by.
In addition to bringing riches to our civilization, this trade route will gradually develop roads between our cities. Roads allow our units to no longer be impaired by the difficult terrain through which they pass.
It's why they're so important, because you can't manually build roads like in Civ 5. Oh, no, that's grassland. Does that have plus one faith? It's plus one faith up here. Yeah, see that one. Oh, no, no. What the hell? Okay.
When you find yourself in a hole,
civilizations early game that is what will give you golden ages. It's very hard to do it by yourself with your near on an island like this. From my previous playthroughs, anyway.
The value of military knowledge, but if men make war in slavish obedience to rules, they will fail.
Specialty district.
Civilizations have uncovered new technologies and civics. And soon the world itself will reach the dawn of a new era. Our actions in this era may lead us into a golden age for our civilization, or perhaps darker days lie ahead.
Thousands have lived without love, not one without water.
Finish building a world wonder Stonehenge. Campus. Science, I don't need that yet. Monument as well. Culture's lacking. Let's do a galley first over here.
My liege. We are beginning to attract the attention of the great people of the world.
Yay.
Of course, there are other leaders vying for their attention too. The more specialized districts we construct, the more we will draw in specialized great people to share their talents with our civilization. The time has come to choose which of our accomplishments to commemorate in our history. This will inspire our people to continue to press forward towards a path of your choosing. History marches forward, and the world has entered a new era. We may see a golden age or a dark age in our civilization's future, born from the actions of our recent past.
Make dedication. So we hit, what, 17? 8 of our citizens exerts a normal amount of 1 loyalty. Pressure in the city. This pressure also affects other cities within 9 tiles, but is 10% less effective per tile. You may make a dedication, which will provide an additional source of era score during the age. Free inquiry. Gain an era score each time you trigger a Eureka moment. higher score for construction building that provides science as a base yield. Van Brush and Voice, Inspiration, or plus one air score for construction of building with a great work slot. Monumental, gain an air score extra. New specialty district, that might be what we need to do. Gain two air scores, jump convert a city to your founded religion for the first time. I'm not close enough to people, I think. A great merchant.
We now have the opportunity to appoint a governor to our civilization.
Yay.
This governor will be a powerful and productive asset when assigned to one of our cities. I suggest.
It was luxuries like air conditioning that brought down the Roman Empire. With air conditioning, their windows were shut. They couldn't hear the barbarians coming.
Here's Square Campus. All builders trained in the city get a build charge. Nice. Frozen towards City Center and Government Plaza buildings. Fishery. Any improvement can be built in the city on coastal plots, yields, some commission, amusement, coastal water park, building city, one culture, one ability to chase the water. Nice, I like Liang. Kyoto.
It was luxuries like air conditioning that brought down the Roman Empire.
Yeah, you just
with
said
air
that.
Conditioning, their windows were shut. They couldn't hear the barbarians coming.
Reduce production in all cities, gold from trade routes, production towards settlers. Settlers. I think we're gonna go with settlers.
Our governor is now on their way to their assigned city.
Yay.
It will take some time for them to become established there. Once established, their talents will come into effect, strengthening our rule there.
City right here, city up there, city over here, city somewhere in this area, city down here. I think that's going to be the best route to go.
Once again, we have the opportunity to enhance our powers of governance. We can use it to promote one of our existing governors, or we can appoint another new governor to our civilization.
Okay. That's a lot of information.
A strong economy begins with a strong, well-educated workforce.
We are now ready to choose where to build our government buildings. We may only zone one of these in our empire, so choose carefully. Now.
I think meeting three city states might be the best governor title. We can promote, and then she gets government plus building stuff. But what I'm gonna do is do the cardinal to other city. Governor's religious units heal fully and one turn in tiles of the city. City ignores pressure of combat effects of religions not founded by the governor's player. Apostates and warrior monks trained in the city receive one extra promotion when receiving their first promotion.
Hello, beautiful.
Ine Cleopatra henna henenes et ir. Iu exalu.
Worthy.
Visit our nearby city and sample our hospitality. I don't know where. I don't see our unit. Don't know how she saw me. She must have been on the coast here and saw this or something. Friendly.
We are by the grace Hello. Of God, Victoria, Queen of the United Kingdom of Great Britain and Ireland.
The Empire.
And soon, dare I say, the Empire.
To do one or two cities here shortly. Don't want to be in a dark age. Come to the next. Oh, Germany.
Set your course by the stars, not by the light of your passing ship.
You speak to actual star of the classic color, but you know it was when Japan discovered celestial navigation. Masonry. Open borders for one gold. One gold for 30 turns is nice. Open borders for 14. No. One gold for 30, yeah, that's fine.
Though our population grows, there is little room for our newest citizens. We should find a way
to add more housing, okay. friends with the smaller civilization. We appreciate that you recognize this fact. Thanks. Anger. You're not worthy of passing a present. Your palace, fragile as your army, is weak. Yay. Waste my time.
You tread on dangerous waters in the face of England and her loyal colony.
Don't care. Hello? See this line is taken or not. That'll tell me whether or not I'm going to build a city here or here. Swing back around.
Your Grace, we have obtained greater knowledge in the art of building static fortifications.
Building walls so they can attack
building
people.
Walls around our cities will not only make them stronger against a foreign invader, but will also allow them to bombard nearby enemies.
When wasteful war shall step.
Opportunity has arrived for a change into a new and more powerful system.
Divide and rule, a sound motto.
Yay. In a city with a district receive plus housing and plus amenity and climate. Influence points per turn towards earning city state envoys. And that was nice. adopts government classic, public leading to a new political age for its citizens. Didn't we just do that? Pacific of New Era, your people celebrate historical monarchy. The philosophy of Japan. For Tier 1 government, your people celebrate historical Japan. Adopts government by classical republic, leading to a new political age for its citizens. Plus 2. And find out a wrap up play. We're about an hour and 10 minutes into the first episode. I will have to say thank you guys for watching if you are watching. Once we get this, we'll know where the iron is, and that's going to take a good precedence of where we want to build our cities from henceforth. God. To campus. No. That's to a harbor. city-state or player. Здравствуйте. Я царь Пётр. Spain?
Достойный правитель, подобный вам, должен ценить всё самое изысканное. Любите ли вы искусство
под... See Russia. It's Russia. I'm gonna meet you. Sample our hospitality, please.
Okay. Bronze is the mirror of the form.
We have no iron. Plaza is done. We're gonna end this episode. Do I have stone yet there? No. Garrison to spend some money to upgrade them. Are you scared for your life? Yeah. So now that these all have roads. Trading post created. Completing a train route has created a trading post for you in the city of Kyoto. Nice. Upgrade to an archer. Cabal. Industrial. Production, production, production. Some iron around here. The
Je suis Catherine. Reine mère de France. Je vous souhaite la bienvenue à mon royaume. J'ai grand désir et envie de découvrir tous vos secrets.
Nice. Where is she at? Is that her way? Oh, that's Germany. Moving things along.
Never again can I gaze upon the beauty spots of the earth and enjoy them as being the finest thing I have ever seen. Crater Lake is above them all.
It's kind of funny, actually. I thought about... I live in the Northwest, and we're not too far away from Crater Lake. Hello, America.
Welcome to the United States of America. If you conduct yourself well, you can consider us friends.
It's an honor. We would love to sample your hospitality. Oh, hi, Boston. Cut us off right there. Trying to block. Oh, wow. Did you guys see that? Those northern, well, in this case, southern lights. That is so cool. I've never seen it in this game before. That is something else.
May I suggest that we construct a government building to memorialize and strengthen our current government?
New government buildings, we unlock a legacy policy based on our currently chosen government. These legacy policies are a powerful reminder of our past and carry forward into the future governments. Choose production. Audience chamber. increased production towards settler city is received by free builder. Awards plus one governor title. Unlocks the Republican legacy policy card. Capturing city gains 20 bonus production in all cities for 5 turns. I like the audience chamber. Two loyalty in cities without governors. Four housing in cities with governors. Like the ancestral hall, that's kind of well rounded. Every new city gets a free builder. Oh, I got an iron spot. Might become a negative later, but we're going to go with the audience chamber. Plaza buildings. I'm going to promote her. Builder trained. Oh, well, we're at the end of the world right here. That's nice. And I'm gonna do that, and I'm gonna bid everybody adieu with our main city here, and our government buildings being built, our holy site, our fishery being built. Close 95. I need another. Hand. Everything's going pretty well. Got that, got that. 2, 4. I'm gonna have to cut those trees down to finish that harbor. Remember how the Germany just declared war on Preslav?
People who cannot find time for recreation are sooner or later to find time for illness.
I'm sure you have constructed a new district. Because of this, you receive air score from your district. Building. bastard's gonna kill Preslav. That German crackhead. Oh, yeah. Oh, where do we want to go? I can't. Your power's fragile as your army is weak. Yeah. Go away. Damn. Oh, what a waste. What can we do real quick? City-states, can we take away? Get.
Wealth consists not in having great possessions, but in having... Cool.
Research. Colossus Wonder. Let's go. I don't understand minor resource. Mining stone. Maybe that has to be iron as well. Alright, guys. Thank you very much for watching. Smash that like button if you'd like to see more. I'd love playing Civ. I could play it every day. I love a leader who's surrounded by oppressive military. So one thinks it's oppressive, one thinks it's horrible. So hit the like button, subscribe, please. I'm trying to get up to 500 so that I can get free games. That's not the way you want to say it. I don't want to get free games. I would love to get games and be able to do videos on them. Say it like that. Alright, guys. Well, thank you very much for watching. And as soon as this stops, and I kind of froze. There we go. Open borders. 10 gold. Got one. I need there's a few things that I need. A religion. There's a lot going on. Let's see if we can get this thing to stop. I don't want to miss out on any turns from next episode, so... Come on, move. There we go. So, I bid you guys adieu. I need to make another settler. I need to finish this building. I need to build another worker. Yeah. Lots to do. Okay, guys, thank you very much for watching. Have a wonderful evening, ladies and gents, and I will see you next time. Bye-bye.